Ooh, level 60 divvy. I'll take it. Almost at 80, right? Kind of. Here we go. That's the end of the Reaper assignment. 7 whole Reaper points. He's absolutely insane. It's about time on this account that we set our sights on the Elven City of Priftiness. In order to get into Prift, you need level 75 in 10 separate skills. If I pull up my stats, we're not particularly close. We've got level 75 in 3 of the 10 skills, and a lot of our skills are in the 50s and low 60s. It looks like we're pretty far off, but I think if we commit to this, we could have Prift a lot quicker than you'd expect. I'm thinking 1, maybe 2 episodes tops. There are some other objectives for this episode as well, but we're gonna start by working on Prif. Because I'm an Iron Man and a solo only account, some of our methods here might be just a little bit questionable, but we're gonna try our very best to get the job done. Before we kick things off, I also just wanted to wish you guys a happy holiday season. Whatever you celebrate, I hope everyone's happy, healthy, safe, all that good stuff, and I will see you guys on the other side. You know, I have a feeling this is gonna be very good money. Oh my goodness. Yeah, that's really good for like a couple minutes work. Let's rinse and repeat. That is about 80 strength coming in and 112 combat. Herbs isn't really worth it. Okay, you know what? We're gonna keep it like this. This is 5 weeks of kingdom I'm gonna claim right now. I'm pretty sure I now have enough logs to get at least 70 construction, maybe even 75, which is one of the prefects. We are gonna need a lot of money to get that done, which is why we're doing 83, but that's a really good start. I am level 94 farming, and I'm pretty sure this is the first time I'm planting a tree on this account, which is both cool and maybe a little sad as well. I've had papaya tree seeds in my bank for a good long while, and I figured I may as well plant them and not actually do tree runs or anything with them, but just loot the papayas that restock every couple hours. I'm not gonna do this often, but I figured if I'm in the area, I may as well. Ooh, level 81 strength. We're actually leveling up so much today. That's not half bad, is it? Shattered Worlds is my least favorite minigame in the entire game. I honestly can't say I enjoy a single aspect of it. I've done it on my main account, and I've also been doing it in secret on my hardcore Iron Man. It's a safe death, so I don't really need to pay too much attention, and I've been working on unlocking the Bladed Dive ability. With this silver challenge completed, I now have 60 million total anima. If I click on this chest and there are 3 million anima inside of it, I will then have 63 million and I will be able to unlock the Bladed Dive ability. This means not only can I Bladed Dive, but I will never have to go back to Shattered Worlds ever again on this account, which is absolutely fantastic to me. Tell me it's a lot. Oh, that's a lot. That is a lot of anima. Okay, hold up. Done! That's Bladed Dive finished. As you can see, I'm getting 640 XP per kill here. And they spawn back instantly.
You know, as fun as it was to throw it back to 2009, I think the Abyss might just be a little bit better. So let's go teleport on the Mage of... Oh, I haven't done the mini quest. 1 second. Mini quest completed.
What level am I going for? So, I need level 75 for Prif. I've got lots of chins. I wanted to explore this method. See if it's good. Because if it's good, this is what we could do all the way to the promised land, you know? Dude, this method seems really, really solid so far. I am quite pleased with it. That's level 60 ranging, like 4 minutes later. And level 87 constitution as well. Right as vampirism is about to expire, we've been here for 1 hour. We went from 58 to 68 ranging, over 300,000 experience, actually closer to 400,000. Actually busted method here. Oh my god! Look, guys, I'm one of the superior Vindicta tanks in the history of the game. And, I don't want to talk about it.
Still doing my Jack of Trades. I don't do it every single day, but I do it whenever I remember. And we are now level 78 Herblore, which means I can use a spicy stew to boost up to Adrenaline Potions. These are the first untradeable potions to be made on the account. I don't know if that's a huge milestone or anything, but I'm pretty happy about it. Also, one more level until we can boost and make super anti-fires.
Large plate of rune salvage. Oh my goodness, get in here. It's more money than I make the boss fight. All right.
That is the end of the Reaper assignment. 12k Slayer XP, 12 Reaper points. You'll love to see it. Let's finish the trip.
If you think this is a bad idea on a hardcore, well, it probably is.
Got it. So, we didn't lose our hardcore doing General Grador. That's always good. I'm literally within a couple hundred life points of Ring of Lifing, but also remember, I did have a sign, so not the end of the world. Construction and summoning are expensive skills, and expensive skills require raw GP. Best way to get that is farming in Elite Dungeon 3, and the levels aren't hurting anything either. I'm getting about 2.2 million coins an hour, along with 1.4 million combat experience as well, so it's pretty OP. Now that we've got some money, let's train our summoning. The two main ways to train summoning are as follows. The expensive and fast way to train summoning is in Taverly selling stuff to the shop, but I am not that dice. The second best way to train summoning is Prif. The third best is a Spirit Grok. So for the second time in one video, we're gonna run it back to the olden days when this was the best way to train summoning. That's level 62 summoning. That's another level done. Okay, yeah, this is fast. 650k XP an hour right now, all right. By the way, if you're wondering what I've been doing for secondaries, I've been making bloated leech pouches with raw beef. You get the raw beef from either the Canifus shop or the Ooglug shop, and it's basically a daily. I don't really show you guys dailies, but I spent weeks buying this stuff every single day, and that's the only reason I'm able to train summoning as effectively as I am right now. So I guess do your dailies, but also don't because they suck, but they're worth it, so maybe do them? I don't know. Is it actually a raw shark for Bunyip? No. Is it a- I don't know if I can get a Bunyip. How am I gonna get a raw shark? Oh, Vindicta! Oh, Vindicta, thank you, Vindicta. All right, I was about to be really sad that we're now 68 summoning and I won't be able to Bunyip up. And then Vindicta has just hit me with 229 Bunyips, free of charge. All righty.
Nice.
My spirit kayak died, but we're almost 70, so I'm just gonna go to Menaphos and run the last couple ones myself. That's level 70 summoning. We're gonna call it there. I have no idea if this still works, but it is a tortoise on our legendary pet. And just like that, we've got a regular tortoise last 40 minutes. And then we're gonna use a terror bird on the legendary pet to extend the tortoise. And if this works correctly, we now have a tortoise that lasts 2 hours, but was made with terror birds? That's some free real estate right there. I'm trying to do as much Vindicta as I've got supplies for, as Dragon Bones are going to be our way to get level 75 Prayer. I think with those bones I just picked up, I should have level 70 banked. All right, this will be kill number 6. 6 kill trip and we got food left over too. I'm out of prayer. Kill boss, please. I beg you. Magic logs again, not bad. And that is my 50th kill count as well. That is an hour of Vindicta done, and we managed to get ourselves 17 kills, which, honestly, for my stats and my gear, is not too bad at all.
Nice.
70 range, we can finally use the Dark Bow and the Careless Crossbow that we definitely don't have. 5 more levels till the Prif Rec, let's keep it going. Aura's just about done, so we're gonna stop at 72. Wait. I just had to kill 2 Arabs. Another day, another Barrows run. Oh my goodness. That's actually so good. Yeah, because I've got a Garb of Subjugation. So now, I guess, augmentable mage legs? Done. Does your boy go back to back? Nope. I figured I'd get done the elite clue that I got from Barrows. That is the 5th elite clue on the account. And yeah, nothing great, but I'll always take some potions. Let's go back to Vindicta. Vindicta? Honestly underrated combat XP. I know we're pretty underleveled for this boss, but you know, we do enough of it and we may not be underleveled anymore. What's that drop? I think that's Dragonhide. Nope, it's actually gems. I'll take it. Most importantly, 18 Reaper points, 17 KSR XP. We almost have the 250 Reaper points needed to double our HP healed from a sign. I have 228, so probably a Reaper or two from Freedom. Unreal.
Nice.
Level 70 in the crafting skill. Another level 70 that's also a Prif Rec. We'll set a new level target to 75. And yeah, what are the unlocks here? Voidseer's back, diamond amulet. Okay, not particularly useful, but I'll take it. That's level 63, Divi. I didn't know you could get a fallen star from a clue on an Iron Man, but apparently you can. So yeah, if anyone asks, I spun for the win. Back in the Shadow Reef, let's make some money for construction. Speaking of things we're a little underleveled for, this. I don't have a good way to get potions or supplies or food or really anything at this point, and this single kill on Bosmic Boss Face took an entire invent and familiar of food. I mean, the XP is absolutely insane, that's about 85 def, but I don't think we can do this every single time. Half an hour later, that's level 85 strength. That's a quick 3 million coins. Nowhere near enough, but that's a start. It's time to build some tables, or the same table. So I found a way to kill Bosmic Boss Face without most of the minions being able to attack, which greatly reduces the amount of food I need, because the minions don't stack on top of each other. So yeah, anyway, significantly better, and with the XP from the boss and the minions, I'm now getting upwards of 2 million combat XP an hour. I have no idea how this is still in the game, and in a group, it's actually even faster. This is just absolutely busted combat XP. Ooh, level 86 strength. Thanks, Bosmic Boss Face. So every single one of these summon skeletons gives you 2.5k XP. So, yeah, that is not surprising at all. That is level 87 defense, but actually more importantly than that, that Bosmic Boss Face kill means I now have 50,000 Dungeoneering tokens. This means I can finally buy myself a Ring of Vigor. I probably should have bought one a really long time ago, but still, better late than never. Now I've got one for any time I'm ulting, I'm gonna save that 10% extra adrenaline. There he is, Ring of Vigor, 50,000 tokens. Gone. Another 3 mil, you know what that means. That is level
nice
construction, which means I can finally boost and make myself a gilded altar. That's obviously going to be a pretty big part of prayer training going forward, as the Wildy altar is kind of off limits. 13 episodes in, and we have a gilded altar. The gilded altar is great to have, but before I use it, I should actually be using the Ectofunctus. Every 200 bones you worship at the Ectofunctus gets you one piece of the first age outfit. That outfit gives you bonus XP and also gives you a chance to save a bone. So before we can actually use our gilded altar, we're gonna go to the Ectofunctus, and it is gonna take a long time. It's been about 5 hours, and I am now level 68 prayer. Grinding up those bones takes an absolutely insane amount of time. I am so glad that's over with. So now all we need to do is get some Marintils, and then it's time to use our gilded altar. That is level 69 prayer. I'm not gonna make the joke again. I can't believe that we've made the joke 4 times in what? That's horrible. That's far over you.
Nice.
Just like that, we are level 70 in the prayer skill. We've now unlocked every single prayer in the book, aside from the Dungeoneering ones, and I can't believe we started Vindicta without getting Piety. That just seems really dumb, but anyway, we've got it now. I'm really, really glad to have it, and that is going to be our best prayer to use for probably the next at least 4 or 5 episodes, because I don't expect to get curses and level 95 anytime soon. This is uncanny. How many times in one video? This has to be some kind of record. Yeah, anyway, that's level 69 cooking. I'm actually not gonna make the joke because I feel like you guys have earned this one. 87 strength. Good work, team. I think that's 75 kill count. And more stone spirits. Oh my goodness, and 90 constitution coming in. Yeah, good luck killing me now, Vindicta. I mentioned at the beginning that I had some slightly more ambitious plans for this video, but before we start that phase of the video, let's take a look at our stats and see how much progress we actually made towards Prif. There were our stats at the start, and here are our stats now. We gained over 40 levels in terms of Prif Rex, and as you can see now, our stats are actually looking pretty close. I'm hoping by the end of the next episode, we'll find ourselves inside the Elven City of Prif. Let's put all that on the back burner for right now. I want to get a Kiln Cape. The fight kiln is really boring at a high level, and it's one of my favorite pieces of content to do on a slightly underleveled or slightly lower level account. So we're going to be going in, no overloads, no curses, and I want to get all the prereq quests done right now. I don't know if we'll actually get the cape, but it is a safe death, so if we do end up flying a little bit too high, at least we're not going to lose our hardcore. I think what's happening is the lava underneath makes it hard to tell. Oh my god, that's so much move! Whoa, dude. Oh my god. You know what? We're going to be eyes on the prize here. I'm not going to kill the other dudes. I'm just going to kill this guy. I'm like out of food almost. Uh-oh. Oh, he's spawning more. Just got to make sure I got the stuns. Good. Cool. Nice. We did it. There we go. Brink of Extinction complete. Got ourselves a 275k XP lamp that I can't use on range. Love this game. 100k mining XP. Beautiful. It's not gonna let me put it on range. I'm not high enough level. Have to be level 80 at least. So let's, I guess we throw it on magic, I suppose. Yeah, give. I had it just like that. Level 84 magic.
Bring of Extinction isn't actually needed to do the fight kiln, but it is needed to make obsidian armor, and because I've actually got all the stats to make it, I figured I may as well get it done, and now I've got my set of armor made. The last thing I need to do before I'm ready to take on the fight kiln is get level 75 range. That way I can use my Vanquish, and it should make it just a little bit easier. From level 58, that literally took less than 3 hours to get all the way up to 75 ranged. Not only can we now equip our Vanquish and do the fight kiln, but that's also a prif rack.
Hey, this could be the first ever piece of best in slot gear on the hardcore. That's kind of exciting, I would say. And done. 1 hour and 6 minutes. Holy moly, dude. 1 hour and 6 minutes. First try, no problem at all. Get that Onyx. No, I'm getting the cape, dude. Wait, Ket? That's the melee one, right? Gotta be. Yeah, Kazil and Med. Yeah, Ket. Melee. Give. Done. There it is. Fight kill done. We can take off our bandos. It's so sick. It's actually so sick. The Bunyip took us to the promised land, boys. We got her done. I now have a nice, shiny, fancy kiln cape to train Slayer in and do anything else I'm doing in.
I'm really glad we got that done. It was actually a lot of fun not having things like Soul Split just to keep me alive losslessly, and I actually felt like I had to think about how I was doing each wave instead of just standing in the middle like you would do on a main account. So anyway, if you're sort of in and around the 120 combat range, definitely try a fight kiln. You might have a good time. With the fight kiln complete, we turn our attention to Prif in the next video. I really hope you guys enjoyed. Feel free to let me know what you liked, what worked, what didn't, and if you didn't enjoy the video, leaving a like and or subscribing to the channel are both really cool things to do. Thank you all so much for watching, have a good one, and I'll see you next time.